Many of you may have heard of cash from clunkers. It's a program in America where you can trade in cars, old gas-guzzling cars, and get new small cars, and you got a lot of money for it. So the idea I came up with was a crazy idea of doing network cash for clunkers, which is trade in if your routers are so old and switches are so old they can't support IPv6. Let the government have an incentive structure to trade those in and upgrade it to IPv6. But in fact, it's not that. In the case of cars are pretty much hardware. They're these big steel things. In the case of IPv6, as you know, it's actually more about the software and the configuration. So there's actually a lot of work that's got to get done. But what we want to think about are national programs. Each country could consider national programs to incentivize the adoption of IPv6 with DNSSEC. So there's a security benefit as well. And those programs could be in the form of tax credits. They could be in the form of accelerated depreciation on the assets, which is similar to a tax credit. Or they could be in the form of subsidies or other development grants. Because there's many different formats can be used. But if the countries of the world could look at using stimulus funds to upgrade network infrastructure, to move to IPv6 and DNSSEC, it'd be really great for the world. And by the way, this is a great role where ITU can help out so many parties. ITU has the relationships with the ISPs and the telecom providers for that physical layer, you know, of upgrading. And again, our little role, ICANN's little role, in this is the network addresses that we allocate to the RIRs. They're available. There's enough addresses for everybody.